By the way, where's Maris? I haven't seen her all night.
She's on your bed.
My bed?
Yes, she's asleep under the guests' coats. She exhausts easily under the pressure to be interesting.
And no one will get hurt.
Just go away. This is no concern of yours.
Yes, it is.
How?
Remember that day in junior high school when somebody took all my clothes while I was in the shower, right after gym class? They hung them from the goalpost on the football field. I had no choice but to get a ladder and climb up there wearing nothing but a towel, wet and shivering. Then the towel fell off. There I was, your little brother, hanging naked from a goalpost, and everyone was standing around laughing, and all Coach Medwick would do was stand there going, whatever that means.
Why are you telling me this?
Because I was so humiliated. Give me the brick, Fraser.
And let him get away with this!
I know. What the gallery owner did to you was wrong. It was humiliating. But if you throw that brick through that window, you will have lost something more valuable than your money. You will have lost your mind. Fraser, you can't do this!
Well, Niles, if you were strong enough to show restraint after so much humiliation, not to mention the nicknames.
Nicknames? There were nicknames?
Oh, you didn't know that? Oh, dear God, yes. Peach Fuzz, Jingle Bells. I can't remember the rest.
Peach Fuzz?
Yes, I believe Coach Medwick made that one up himself. Well, anyway, here you are. I won't be needing this anymore.
I'm proud of you. I've struck a blow for justice. Nobody calls me Peach Fuzz. Now let's get the hell out of here.
We've got a free evening. Sounds like the perfect opportunity for a couple of guys on the loose to hit a sports bar, have a couple of brewskis, maybe take in a game or two.
Right. But what shall we do?
Well, I had to. What with you underneath the covers with a flashlight looking at the National Geographics?
I was looking at the maps.
That's what makes it so scary.
You're here. I came by to see how you're doing, but I only have a few minutes. I start my Healing with Humor support group tonight, and I still have to pick up my big shoes.
I like the company.
So, how's Dad's therapy going?
Well, we're getting more mobility in his hip, and his flexibility's improving, but it's always a chore to get him to do his exercises. Of course, I've found the secret is if I bribe him with sweets, then...
Have you seen that movie? Maris and I rented the video. I don't mind telling you, we pushed our beds together that night. And that was no mean feat. Her room, as you know, is across the hall.
Hello, Niles.
Hi, son.
Laughter, and Creasel's mocking voice as he'd hoist me over the bowl. Hold your breath, Jocko. Then the crowd would start its awful chant. There goes Crane, down the drain. There goes Crane, down the drain.
Niles!
I'd rather you be a bully than one of those wussy kids that always gets picked on. You know the kind I'm talking about? The kids who are too gutless to fight back.
So, you admire someone who fights back, do you?
Well, sure! I mean...
What's Dr. Crane doing?
He's a little frustrated because I wouldn't let him do something. He's taking his anger out on my ficus.
I've never seen him so angry. He's like a madman.
Good Lord! There's a bee out there the size of a woodfinch.
Oh, jeez, the disposal's jammed. Yeah, stick your hand on there and see what's stuck, will you?
Dad, it's me, Niles.
I can't get my hand in there.
Oh, all right, punish a man for being fine-boned. You sure it's off?
Positive.
Move away from the switch.
Jeez.
Oh, ho, it's wet and slimy and God knows what. It's like sticking my hand into the mouth of hell. Yeah!